Hello, welcome to Guy's Art Studio. Today I have a reasonably quick painting for you using watercolour and black ink and a bit of pen. I've drawn out on the watercolour paper an image of Polegate High Street, which is a little East Sussex town nestled in the South Downs. Drawn out the High Street and the level crossing and a windmill in the background with the downs. This is a water soluble ink. Once it's dry, it doesn't move with the water. But you can mix a bit of water with it at the beginning. Just putting some shapes on the downs now, some trees, some bushes in the distance, keeping it very watery, wet on wet. Dropping some ink into the water, watching it flow. Damp brush there, and I just soften the edge so we don't get too much of a hard edge on it. Mixing in with the black ink a little bit of watercolour paint. I think there's a little bit of cad red with this. Going in with the hairdryer, paint and the water. Sometimes you want the paint and the paper to be wet, and other times you want it to be dry. Putting a bit of water where the downs are now, cutting in with a brush around the windmill, and in details on the chimneys or roofs that are in front. This is in the distance, so just added a little bit of ink, a very, very small amount of green, I think I added. I think it was viridian green, but the smallest amount of green. See the paper's quite wet here. Ink mixed with a tiny bit of paint is running and moving and making its own patterns in the water. Just putting in some marks on the downs, some paths, some bushes. Subtle details. A little bit of cadmium red mixed in with it. Picking up some details now of the buildings, looking for where the shadows would be, picking out the areas of shade within the windows, adding water and then dropping in the same colour. This building here that I'm painting used to be Buckley's newsagents. It's a side-on view of it, just past the level crossings in Polegate. with this painting, I've deliberately not used a ruler or tried to make any of the lines straight. Let them wiggle a little bit. Let the roof lines and chimneys and the wall lines look a little crooked. That's all okay, all adds character. I want the windmill to be part of the image, but I don't want it to be about, it's not about the windmill as such. So I've made sure the windmill's there, but it's not the focal point. Keeping the colours not back the same as the background. I'm starting to do the roofs now of the building that's the closest to us. And I've decided to make them darker, bring them forward, bring them closer to you. But I'm not painting in the tiles or even an image of tiles really. I'm just dotting in the ink and letting it flow and make its own patterns. Trying to create a piece of art here, not a photograph, so it doesn't need to look like tiles for me. You can see where I've added the water before, it swirls around in the water and makes its own way. picking out details of the crossing. The lights, and the gates, and the fence. details on the street lamp going in now. Some old fashioned looking street lamps at Polegate. Adding some details in there where there's a parade of shops in the foreground. Used to be a bank and a pet shop. I think the chemist is still there. Trying to add a little bit more detail, but not too much. Add in a little bit more colour, a little bit more red into the black, a little bit of yellow, probably cad yellow, cad red. Just bring in a bit of warmth to the image. So there we have it, quite simple little watercolour there. Not too many different colours. Nice warm picture. View of Polegate High Street with the downs and the windmill behind. In the centre of the image is the old Buckley's newsagent. Hope you've enjoyed watching me create this little bit of artwork. Maybe it's inspired you to have a go yourself. Don't always have to paint the colours that you see in front of you. Make it up. I decided to just do these warm tones, add a bit of pen and ink. Thank you very much for watching this very quick watercolour painting simple colours. Hope you've enjoyed it, and please check out some of my other videos on my channel. Thank you for watching Guy's Art Studio. Please click like if you can, and maybe share it with someone else who may be interested.